it's going to be messy. It's going to be sloppy. It's going to be awkward. It's going to be uncomfortable. I got the most juicy comment on one of my videos asking about sex and how I feel about having sex after Adam comes home after not doing it for so long. Am I insecure? Do I have reservations? Am I scared? Am I excited? Am I nervous? Every single emotion. So if you're interested in all of those juicy details and how I feel about that, please keep watching. If you're new here, my name is Ro. I'm the founder of an organization called Strong Prison Wives and Families, the author of a book called The Comeback Code. We do not glorify or glamorize prison life, or prison wife life here. But I will teach you how to make the best out of this unfortunately really painful and hopefully one-shot deal. I got this question from one of you guys. I'll read it to you and then we'll go through the answer. This one is really, really juicy and I'm excited. She thought I wasn't gonna answer it, but I am no secrets, no holds barred. You guys have an up front row and center. You guys have a front row and center seat into my life because I use my experiences to hopefully help and teach you. And if that comes along with admitting embarrassing things and talking about uncomfortable topics, I'm all about it. One of you guys asked, Ro, I hope all is well with you, Adam, and the rest of your family. I have a question for a video. If you don't want to answer, I understand, but if you're looking for a video idea and don't mind talking about it, I'm curious. Are you nervous about having sex with Adam when he gets out? I feel like the long buildup is nerve-wracking. I don't know if it's normal or if other people are just excited after a long wait. I'd love to know what you think. Thanks. Oh, juicy. I love it. I am so excited to talk about this because I don't think enough people share. Well, not really many people talk about prison wife life on YouTube anyway, but I don't think enough people talk about this. Let me start with this dream I had the other night because it's so soothing. So I had this dream that Adam got out, just got news, got out, was like, come pick me up. I had no preparation. I had no time to get ready for that. You have to remember, if you don't have a loved one who's incarcerated, if you're here just because you support me on my channel and want to learn more about it, oh, I love you for it. Let me explain to you. Most people have a countdown. Most people have time to prepare. And that can be obviously a blessing. It's the best case scenario, but also it can work against them a little bit because sometimes you can get caught in the monotony and eat crap and gain weight and let the house get a mess because you have this many years to waste and then can prepare for him to come out 6 months, 5 months, 5 weeks, whatever it is, before he comes home. And I always tell all of you guys that old habits die hard. You can't pack on pounds for 10 years and expect to lose all that weight for him to come home in a matter of a year. You could crash diet and get it off in a couple of months, but what did that do to your health in between? So I'm going down on a tangent. My point in sharing that with you is majority of the time, you have time, months, weeks, years to prepare for your loved one to come home usually. But in a case like Adam's, if he gets clemency, if he's awarded his release, most likely, not definitely, but it's possible that he can get a call and they're like, you're allowed to come home, have somebody come pick you up. And I have to be ready in a split second. So we had talked about this a little bit last week. He got me so stressed out because he's like, it could happen soon. That's just Adam. That's his hope. We'll go into that another time. People have kind of bashed me about that. And I really have taken steps back talking about the possibilities because I don't want to make him come out like a bad guy, come across like a bad guy, because that's not the case. Anyway, stay tuned. More about that hopefully in the near future. So I go to bed that night. We have this long conversation. I'm like, you're freaking me out. You're stressing me out. Just stop it. I'll take care of it when it happens, but stop. Because we've been in quarantine for 3 months. I don't have time to dye my hair, to wax, to get a manicure, to get a pedicure, let alone to take off this quarantine weight that I've gained. I've gained a lot of body fat during quarantine because I'm eating foods that I wasn't always eating. I'm not moving around as much. Yes, I'm exercising, but I am not doing exercises with my group training gym, so I'm not training the way that I was before because I don't have the equipment that was available to me or weights. Regardless, I'm at a point right now where I'm not the most comfortable with my physique because it's not where it usually is. It's just a personal thing. Hell, we're in quarantine, we're safe, that weight will come off. Not a big deal. However, this is all going on in my mind. So I go to sleep that night and I wake up from this crazy dream. Again, a dream, it's fake, it did not happen. I need to emphasize. I'm gonna put something on the screen here while I'm talking about a dream. This way, if somebody comes in and they're watching this video now, I don't want them to think that this is real. Dream, dream, dream. I'm gonna do something that shows that I'm talking about a dream. Help me out, you guys, in the comments. If somebody is not understanding, they're coming in right now, let them know. Maybe I'll put like dream music. But I have this dream that Adam calls me, hey, I'm coming home. And I go to pick him up. And then I realize that, oh my God, I have not gotten waxed because I can't. So I keep leaving him. I keep making these really dumb excuses to leave him to try to go find a place to get a wax without admitting it to him. Honestly, in real life, I'd just be like, hey, bro, I need a wax, okay? So I'm just, give me a few. Let's go to Walmart, I need some razors, something like that. I have a wax kit that I used, by the way, but this is my dream. So I keep leaving him, and finally, it's been like days, and I leave him for days at a time because quarantine, salons aren't open, can't get waxed. I guess this is an insecurity in the back of my mind. Finally, he comes to the point where he's insecure about it, obviously, of course, can you imagine from his position? And he's like, that's it, I'm done. I don't wanna do this anymore. You don't wanna be by me, you don't wanna be with me, this was fake all of these years, I'm done. And I was like, no, and for some reason in my dream, I was still embarrassed to admit to him that it was only because I was going to find some place where I could get waxed so I could be more confident for the first time we have sex after all of these years. Ever, because we never had sex before in the past. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I admitted this to him. Of course, I told him on the phone. He was laughing so hard, and he's like, please don't worry. Who cares? If this happens, it's not that big of a deal. So that is just a fun story for me to set the tone about how I feel. Am I freaked out about having sex the first time in all of this time? The first time ever with Adam after not having it for over a decade? Of course. This is what plays out in my mind. These are my personal insecurities and my fears, and I'm passing them along because hopefully somebody can relate. The last time Adam was with a woman, he was 23 years old. We're in our 40s now. My body looks very different in my 40s than it did in my 20s. He says he doesn't care, and he doesn't, but in my head, I care. So that's one thing. The second thing is, I haven't been touched in so long. I'm sure you guys can relate. In the past, where I would be in between boyfriends and I wouldn't have been touched for a long time. The next time I was in a relationship and finally touched, there's that weird feeling where when somebody touches you, you jump. It's this weird automatic nervous system reaction. You're not doing it. But I remember one time we were in visit and Adam said something funny, or I don't remember, but I was flirting with him and I poked his side and he had that automatic jump response. And it was shortly after he moved to a medium from a penitentiary. So we weren't even allowed to touch at visit. He was still very, very wound up, but I could feel when I poked his side, I could feel the stomach, the nerves tense up themselves. So, or the muscles tense up themselves. It's an awful feeling. It happens to me now if I go to the doctor, the gynecologist, and he turned to me when I poked him after he jumped and he said, oh, I didn't even know I was ticklish. Where I don't think it necessarily tickled him, it might have, but I think it was just that natural being touched after so long, that natural reaction. And I know that's going to happen, and that is okay. So I think in these types of relationships, we get caught in the fantasy. We have all this time to dream about the way that that first experience after all this time is going to happen, and it's gonna be perfect, and there'll be roses on the bed, and they'll be in horror, and it'll go X, Y, and Z. Well, think about it like this. Your fantasy might be different from his fantasy. We have to take steps out of our own shoes. And I told this to one of my friends, and then I told it to Adam, and he kind of laughed at me. And I was like, no, I'm serious. No matter what that fantasy is, we have to remember that the first time that we're intimate with somebody after so long, it's gonna be messy. It's gonna be sloppy. It's gonna be awkward. It's going to be uncomfortable. That's okay. Lean into that. Go into it knowing all of those things. And that's kind of what can make it fun. I think anywhere in life, not just in the bedroom, but anywhere in life, including the bedroom, when things get awkward and we ignore them, it almost makes it more awkward. But if things get awkward and we lean into it and we make a joke out of it, especially with the person that we're being intimate with, the person that we're supposed to be closest to, if we make a joke out of it and have fun with it and laugh at the awkwardness and embrace the sloppy, uncomfortable weirdness, I think it'll be fun. It'll be an experience that we can treasure because we're both weird. We both haven't done this in so long. So my thought and what I want to pass along to you guys is take all of the ideals off of it. I mean, sure, fantasize, enjoy the fantasy when you're living that part of it, but take all of the pressure off of yourself when it actually comes time to do it. Enjoy it. And here's the best part. You get to keep practicing, my friends, and practice makes perfect. There's no better situation in my head that I wouldn't mind to continue practicing, right? I'll tell you another funny story. I had a friend, when I first got back in touch with Adam, her boyfriend was also locked up. And we're just developing our relationship. We're just relearning each other, getting to know each other again. I'm still very shy. I was even more back then, even though I still am now. And she's like, you gotta do me a favor. I said, what? She said, you need to ask Adam, how do guys prepare for that? What do they do? Do they start doing more alone time in the shower, taking care of themselves in order to build up their stamina and to prepare for that? But she said it in like a vulgar way. How do I even say that to you? I don't, just know, you just know. And I looked at her and I said, no. I was like, absolutely not. Years later, I told him, but I was like, no, your boyfriend can figure it out on his own. And it's not anything you need to know because that's an awkward conversation for me to have with Adam right now. Uh-uh. Listen, my thing is, and this is what I told Adam and he kind of nervously giggled at me, but I think it's the truth. It's gonna last 20 or 30 seconds the first time. Who cares? Have fun with it. Enjoy your 20 or 30 seconds. Enjoy the fact that it's over because it's going to be sloppy and weird, and then move on and just keep practicing and it'll get better. Just like anything else gets better as you do more of it, as you learn each other, as you learn likes and dislikes, as you get more comfortable within your own skin, because time usually has passed before they come home and we age and maybe you've gained some weight and maybe gravity has taken its toll on your physique. It's all okay. The way that I make myself feel better about that is this. He has been around only men for the past, in my situation, 20 years. Yes, there are female cops and COs, but they're few and far between. And when they see them, they're wearing a masculine looking uniform. Some of them are gorgeous. That it is what it is. He's not been around a naked woman in all of this time. So no matter what my body looks like, no matter where I feel like I have dimples or gravity has taken its toll, pointing to the spot, I still have curves and a softness and femininity to my curvy, dimply, beautiful body. A woman's physique is gorgeous, no matter what shape, no matter what size, no matter what age, especially to a man in comparison to only living with men and taking showers with men for all these years. And for all of you women who are in relationships with women, it's the same thing. They have not seen your body. They have, if you're a woman who's in a relationship with a woman, she's waiting to see your body. That's what she's craving and that's what she's attracted to. Or a gay man with a man, same thing. They're waiting for you. That's what makes it special. That's what you have to tell yourself. I got a phone call and I lost my train of thought, but I'll finish with this. I can imagine that we all get lost in the fear of, it's been so long. What if I forget what to do? What if I'm not good at it anymore? What if I don't like things that I used to like? All of these things in our heads. I get like that. I think of that all the time. Here's what I think. It's like riding a bike. Awful choice of words, but it's true. It's something that I don't think you'll just forget how to do. Even if you're out of practice, practice makes perfect. And I can't imagine what better activity to continue to practice and get better at with the person that you adore and you love and you've been waiting to do with this with for all of this time. You have the choice, as you do in any aspect or any area of life. You get to choose if you'll get stuck and trapped in thoughts of lack and negative and, oh my God, I look so bad and I'm so fat and I'm so different from the way it used to be, or my body looks so different from the way that it used to, and I'm probably not good at this anymore, and I'm scared because he's been inside for 20 years working out, building this Adonis God body, and I've been out here busting my ass, not even having time to go to the gym because I'm working to keep a roof over our children's heads, so now I'm concerned. You can get lost in all of that. Or you can just keep telling yourself, this is what we've waited for so long. I'm taking off ideals. It could be sloppy. It could be awkward. It could be uncomfortable. It could be weird. While we still get to know each other, but together we can laugh about it, have fun, enjoy it, and continue to practice until it's perfect. So that's what I'll leave you guys with today. Let me know in the comments below what you think, what you've struggled with. If you want me to make more videos like this, I'm an open book, whatever you guys want. If you are interested in a video Adam and I did together where we talked about intimacy in our relationship and the first time we explored it in a letter and over the phone, click that video there. And then if you're not already subscribed, do me a favor and click that little button right there. Or you can always do so by clicking the red button below. Give this video a thumbs up. I love you guys and I'll see you in the next one.